families, how are you all doing today? My name is Marie, and I work here at the Early On at Luminous Community Services. In this video, we are going to be exploring three different experiments because this video is all about being a little scientist. Let me tell you the three different experiments that we will be doing today. First is an ice melting experiment. Second is our change of color experiment. And the third one is using a pendulum to knock down different things. Okay, let us now proceed to our first experiment, the ice melting experiment. And let me tell you the materials that you would need. Ta-da! You would need three different containers. 1, 2, 3. And you would also need to put 3 pieces of ice cubes in each container. You would need a spoon, and you would need salt, baking soda, and sugar. I have labeled the item with the container. I have number 1 for salt. I have number 2 for baking soda. And I have number 3 for sugar. Now, all we need to put is 2 spoons of each of the materials. So let me put the salt. One and two. Next, we'll put in 2 tablespoons of baking soda. One and two. We're going to tap that a little bit, and we are now going to put 2 tablespoons of sugar. One and two. Great. Now we will leave the materials for 15 minutes, and the timer starts now. I will first put these materials on the side, and we'll be back in a second. Now let's go to our second experiment, which is the color changing experiment. In this experiment, we are going to be exploring primary colors and secondary colors. Let me first tell you the materials that we would need. First, you would need to have clear containers. This will enable you to see the colors more clearly. Next, you would need to fill up with water. I have filled each container with water. Next, you would need to have the primary colors. What are the primary colors? Let me tell you. We have blue. We have yellow. And we have red as our primary colors. Now we're going to be adding 1 drop of each of the colors. Let's do it together. 1 drop of red. 1 drop of blue. 1 drop of yellow. And now you can see the colors. Red, blue, and yellow. Now let's see what will happen if we add another color. Let's try to add blue with the color yellow. I've added 2 drops. Let's see how the colors are changing. Wow! I am going to be using a spoon to mix it up. Make sure that you have a paper towel for some messy spills or if you want to wipe something. I am going to slowly mix the 2 colors together. Ta-da! As what you see here on our chart, it now has turned into color green. Blue and yellow makes the color green. Now, let's try to see how we can make the secondary color, which is orange. For orange, we need to have yellow, which we already have. We need to add red. Okay, so let's do that together. So yellow plus red. I put 2 drops. And we're going to slowly see how it will turn into orange. And I'm going to use my spoon to fully blend the 2 colors. Slowly mixing. And let's see, it turned into orange. Yellow plus red equals orange. Great. Now we're going to make the secondary color, which is violet. For violet, we would need the color red and blue so that it turns into the color violet. We currently have the color red, and I put 1 drop of red. Now let's see and get the blue food color. And you can see how it's slowly swirling to the bottom of the container. Now I'm going to get my spoon and I'm going to mix the 2 colors together. I'm going to show you with the paper towel how it turns out to be purple. The color here is very dark, so it's really hard to tell the color purple. I'm going to take a little bit of food color. And now you can see the color violet. Here is the color violet. Great. And now we will talk about how we turned the colors again to refresh our memory. So, to create the color green, we need to have the colors blue and yellow makes the color green. To create the color orange, we needed yellow plus red equals orange. Next, to create the color violet, we needed the colors blue and red to create the color violet. And to show violet, you would need to have a light background, such as this, a white background, to show violet. I hope that you enjoyed experiment number 2. Now we're going to do experiment number 3, which is creating a pendulum. Let us go to our 3rd experiment, which is the pendulum activity. In this activity, you would need to have some bowling pins, or if not, you can also use your paper towel rolls. Here I have 4 paper towel rolls that I will be using as my pins. And you would need to find a stick. If you don't have any popsicle sticks, you can also use a marker, but making sure that you are able to put a tape on the string on your marker or sticks, okay? So you would also need any type of string that you might have at home, and you would need 3 different types of balls. The balls that I have are different in terms of its size and its weight. This ball is way lighter than this ball with water. And this ball has some beads inside. It does make a funny sound. Okay, the length of your strings should all be the same. As you can see, the length of my strings are all the same, and I have securely taped the edges of the string just like this. Make sure that they all have the same length. Okay, now let's move on to the setup. So you would need to put your paper towel rolls or bowling pins on the ground, and they need to have a distance between each other. Let me show you. Then you would need to choose one ball to try first. Which one do you think can knock all 4 paper towel rolls faster? You would have to swing the ball in a circular motion and keep one hand still and lower it down until it reaches all the paper towel rolls, just like this. We have accomplished knocking down all the paper towel rolls using a light ball. Let's try it with a second pendulum. I am going to use the ball that has the medium weight. Going to spin the pendulum in a circular motion. Great! It worked pretty well too. Now let's try with our third pendulum, which has the water inside, and it's quite heavy too. So let's try it out and see how it feels, knocking down all these paper towel rolls. In a circular motion, here it goes. Wow, it doesn't really reach that far. There it goes, great swing. With the different types of pendulum that you have at home, you can compare how easy it is to knock down different paper towel rolls or bowling pins that you have at home. Compare the weight, compare the sizes, and compare how it feels when you are turning them into a circular motion. Okay, so now let's find out what happened to our ice experiment. 15 minutes is up. Ding, ding, ding. Okay, so now let us take a look at the ice that we have put together a while ago. The first one was salt. We put 2 tablespoons of salt on the ice. Number 2, we put 2 tablespoons of baking soda on the ice. Third, we placed 2 tablespoons of sugar on the ice. Now, let us compare the effects of these different materials on ice. The first one has really melted even to the middle of the ice. And you can tell that it is very, very watery. With baking soda, it does look like there is snow with the ice. Let me pick up one piece. It has melted a portion of it, but it hasn't really melted most of the pieces. As you can tell, they're very big still, and they're quite intact. The third one is with sugar. As you can see, they are still very much connected with each other, and it hasn't really melted. So children, what material do you think made the ice melt the fastest in 15 minutes? Do you think it was the salt? Was it baking soda? Or was it sugar? And the winner is salt. Salt melt the ice the quickest. I hope that you enjoyed the three experiments that we explored in today's video. Parents, I encourage you to continue doing some of these experiments at home. Until next time, we'll see you again. Have a great day, and I hope that you are staying safe and healthy at home. Bye!